Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. Today we are going to continue the chapter of 1, that is matter in our surrounding. In the last part, that is part 1, we have been discussed what are the characteristics of matter. So here we are going to discuss about some of the important points which have been related to the part 1. First, we will go to what are the 3 states of matter. Okay, we do all know that 3 states of matter are solid, liquid and gas. Fine. Apart from that, in this chapter we are going to learn only the definition of 2, that is one plasma, another one is Bose-Einstein condensed. Okay, fine. You may be very familiar with the solid, liquid and gas, which you know that solid, they are already packed, fine, and they do have a shape and volume. But a liquid, they are non-rigid, they do not have a fixed shape, they take the shape of the container in which we keep them. They have a fixed volume. If you take 1 liter, if you pour it that again into a tumbler or any bucket, the water volume will be remaining the same. Coming to the gas, it also does not have rigid, no fixed shape, no volume. It is in the form of gas. You can take an example of gas cylinder, gas, a fog, scent, okay. Okay, before going further, let us first understand that, okay, in the solid, intermolecular space is already packed. Okay, fine. I think so you understood by this, you know it. Intercellular space in solid is greater. In liquid, intercellular space is little bit present. In gas, intermolecular space is more. You can see in solid it is already packed, so intercellular space will be less. Coming to the next, according to the conversion of matters, okay, in this we all know that, as I gave you an homework in the part 1, you need to learn some of the definitions and write it in the notebook. Okay, if you have done so, you will be very much familiar with these words which I am going to tell you now. First one, if you take some water in a in a bowl or a glass, and if you keep it in a fridge, what happens, you can see that the liquid will be converting into a solid. Okay, so the process of converting liquid into a solid, we call it as a freezing. Fine. If you keep this solid out, okay, it will gather the temperature from outside and it will convert itself or melt into a liquid. So solid will be converting into a liquid, that is melting point. Okay, I think so you are familiar now with solid to liquid, it is melting point. Then liquid to solid, it is a freezing. Fine. Now let us move to the next one. When we boil the liquid, okay, you see the some of the vapors coming out. That is what the gas, okay, that means it is boiling. Okay, when you on the gas, okay, that means not a cylinder, when you cook a food, okay, you can see some of the water droplets moving upside. If you keep a lid, okay, what you can see that this water vapor which moves up will be condensed on a plate which you kept like a lid. Okay, so gas converting into a liquid, so you will call it as a condensation. Am I clear still here? Okay, now we are able to understand how many melting point, melting, freezing, boiling, condensation. Everybody knows that water converts into vapor. as in water cycle you have been studied, that is evaporation. Yes, okay, come let us move to the downer. Okay, now we are familiar with melting, freezing, condensation, evaporation. Now a solid without going into the change of liquid, solid, liquid, it does not, it directly changes into a gas, so we call it as a sublimation. An example which you can take here, it is a naphthalene ball. In summer, after winter season, what does the parents do, mother? She wash our clothes and she keeps in a cupboard, and she keeps a naphthalene ball, whitish color one. And after some days or months, few months, what you will be able to see, that this naphthalene ball disappears. This is what happens in a naphthalene ball, that is sublimation. Without convert, the solid does not converts into a liquid. It directly converts into a gas. You are able to smell the clothes. Okay, fine. I think so you are clear now with smelting, freezing, boiling, condensation, evaporation, and sublimation. Fine? Okay, next. Before going further, you will be having a... 1 minute. Okay, latent heat of fusion. Okay, here you can see it is the heat okay fine latent heat of fusion. Here sometimes we put the solid outside and we do not we never check that is temperature, but internal the force of attraction will be going on. The change which has been taken place from conversion of itself from a solid to liquid state, so the force of attraction between the particles, okay, which we apply to change the state, that we call it as a latent heat. There are two types of it. One is, as you can see here, latent heat of fusion. It is required to convert a solid into a liquid state as a melting point. Fine. Okay, the next one is latent heat of vaporization. It is the heat required to convert liquid into a vapor state. Okay, coming back to here, you can see when a solid converts itself into a liquid, the temperature which is being present around it to break the solid particles itself, okay, it needs some of force of attraction to lose itself and converts into a liquid, which we do not absorb with our eyes very clearly, but there will be a change in the solid to convert itself into a liquid. Fine. Now let's come in to understand the topic of sublimation. Here, as we have studied in the earlier, that sublimation means what? Converting solid directly into a gas. We took an example of naphthalene. That process we are going to study in detail. First, you need to learn the definition. Okay, the requirement which you required is funnel. Okay. China dish, tripod stand, burner, ammonium chloride, a cotton. Fine. Now what you need to do, in a China dish, take ammonium chloride, okay, and invert the funnel, okay, and at down you are heating it. So as you heat it, this substance which is in China dish start to evaporate. So what we are doing at the node of a funnel, we are putting a cotton over there so that the vapors cannot be escaped out. We need to see that. Okay, so what happens? Ammonium chloride will start evaporating out, but it cannot go out because we have kept what? At the node of a funnel, we have kept a cotton. So the ammonium chloride will solidify on the stem of the funnel. So you can collect it and see it. Another example which you can take is your Kapoor, which we call it as in Hindi, camphor we call it as. Okay, same. It is solid like substance in puja you use it. It converts that, it's a solid, it converts itself into a gaseous form. It does not leave any residue out. Fine? Okay. All full experiment, how it is been done, everything is been given here. You need to learn this one also with the fully labeled diagram. Fine. Now coming to the next very important topic, that is evaporation. We know that evaporation means changing of liquid into a vapor. Now in this we do have 4 points. Okay. We know that when temperature, you should remember all this. There are 4 points you need to write also. Temperature, surface area, humidity and wind speed. When temperature increases, evaporation increases. Fine. Second, surface area increase, evaporation also increase. I repeat once more. Temperature increase, evaporation also increase. Surface area increase, evaporation also increase. Fine. Third one, it's just an opposite. Where first you need to learn the definition of humidity. Humidity, the water vapor present in the atmosphere. So the rate of evaporation decreases when rate of humidity increases. Fine. Fourth, the last one. Evaporation increases with the increase in wind speed. Fine. Okay, and now there are some questions which answers are already I have just scrolled in the next slide answers, but you need to understand all this what are. So first of all, let me tell you what is this acetone. Acetone means a liquid which we use it in our nail polish. Okay, when we put it in on our palm, it absorbs it. Fine. Okay, before going to this particular part of questions, first you need to learn that what is kinetic energy, which you have been heard about it in physics or in your science classes before, but in chemistry it is very simple. That means it is being changed from what you can call energy, which is being possessed by a body due to its motion. As you know, the kinetic energy comes in a chapter of motion. That means when it is changing from one state to another state, so it possesses some of the energy. That energy we call it as a kinetic energy. Fine. Okay, let us go to the answers quickly so that you may be clear. The first question which I asked you is, how does evaporation causes cooling? Okay, here as an answer we have given, the particles of liquid absorb energy from the surrounding to regain the energy which it is lost during what? Evaporation. This causes cooling. Evaporation causes only cooling. Fine. Next one, when you put a acetone on your palm, okay, this palm, why you feel it cool? Because it is a volatile liquid. Volatile means when you keep it outside, it straightforward evaporates out like a petrol. So it evaporates quickly at room temperature. So when acetone is put on your palm, it evaporates and our palm feels very cool. It absorbs energy which is being present here. Fine. In hot summer day, okay, when we sprinkle water on the ground after the sunny day, what happened, the water droplet absorb the heat of the floor. This will use this hidden form of heat. Means we are not seeing anything. So hidden means latent heat or latent heat form to overcome intermolecular force of attraction and change into gaseous state. This process of changing into gas without reaching its boiling point, we call it as an evaporation. And the fourth question which is been here, it is, why should we wear cotton clothes in summer? We all know that we wear cotton clothes in summer because, first thing, cotton is a good absorber, okay, of a sweat, and we tend to sweat a lot in summer. So cotton clothes provide better air circulation, leading to more absorption of sweat and thus give us a cooling effect. Fine. And the last but not the least, fifth one. Why do we see water droplets on the outer surface of the glass containing a ice cold water? Here I have just taken an example to explain you that soft drink. Pepsi or Coca-Cola, whatever you wish. Okay, fine. The water, when a cold drink bottle is kept open in an air, the water droplet present in the surrounding air condense on the bottle. Not that the water is not coming from, the coolness of water is not coming from inside, but from the outside atmosphere, water vapor which is being present surrounding air condense on the bottle. So the water molecules are slowed down and stick to the surface to the cold. Fine. These water droplets are seen as dew on the surface of the bottle. Clear? Okay. The next one, you need to learn only the definition of it. Here, the fourth one is plasma, as I said you. Ionization. Here, the plasma is in a gaseous state whose atom has lost some or all their electrons. Fine. The gas is a form of ions, like Na plus Cl minus. Okay, fifth one is Bose-Einstein condensation. It is formed on cooling a gas at extremely low density. And you need to learn both of this definition. And the last part which is there is the sums. Okay, to solve the sums, we are not going to take the full value of 273.114117, whatever it is, we are going to take an accurate value, that is 273. Okay, convert the following temperature to Celsius scale, 300 Kelvin and 573 Kelvin. Here, what we need to do here, it is, as we know that we need to subtract it with the Kelvin, that is 273. Fine. We are not going to take it in a points. We are going to take it in accurate. That is 273. We need to minus by 300 minus 273. It is 27. Fine. And the next one, 573 minus with 273, you will get 300. Okay. This is for converting into Celsius scale, means K to C, Celsius scale, Kelvin to Celsius. Now the next part is you need to convert the Kelvin Celsius to Kelvin. First it was K to C, now it is C to K. Here we need to just add it on. Fine. Suppose if you have given 25 degrees Celsius, just you need to plus with Kelvin 273, that is 273 plus 25 is equal to 298 Kelvin. Am I clear? I think so. Everybody understood what are all things which I have been mentioned here, or whichever things which I have taught you. Everything you need to sums you need to do in notebook, definitions you need to learn, sublimation you need to draw and write with explanation, factors affecting with all the definition and all the question and answers. Okay, fine. Thank you. I hope so you understood all. Thank you.